lightning. More powerful than the pounding surf. Mightier than a roaring hurricane. This amazing stranger from the planet Krypton, the Man of Steel, Superman. Possessing remarkable physical strength, Superman fights a never-ending battle for truth and justice. Disguised as a mild-mannered newspaper reporter, Clark Kent.
Dr. Jordan, yet you admit these fingerprints are yours.
Yes, but you don't...
That's all. Kent speaking.
Hello, Daily Planet. This is Dr. Wilson of the Egyptian Museum. I've just uncovered something that may free Miss Hogan.
Yes, Doctor. I've been feeling much better lately, but I'll be right over. I'll see you later, Lois. Doctor's orders.
Doctor, my eye.
Dr. Jordan was the world's foremost student of hieroglyphics. Most of our priceless specimens were brought back by him. Even the mummy of King Tush. Among his possessions, I uncover this ancient Egyptian tablet and find it to be a secret curse of the tomb of King Tush. He who disturbs the eternal sleep of King Tush shall perish. This tablet may well be Miss Hogan's passport to freedom. Come with me, please. Valley of the Upper Nile was ruled by an old and powerful king. He had been warring with the Lower Nile for many years, and just before the old king died, he called his son to him, a young boy of 12. He commanded his giant guards to swear an oath of eternal allegiance to the boy prince, to guard him constantly in this world and the next. Shortly after, the old king died. The youth of 12 now ruled the kingdom of 10 million people, but the boy was not fashioned for such responsibility, and being of a sickly nature, soon became ill himself. Never was a person attended more faithfully than this youth, yet he withered away and soon died. True to their oath of allegiance, each of the royal guards drank poison, so that they might continue to protect the spirit of their young king in the Valley of the Dead. Here in these catacombs, Dr. Jordan has reconstructed the burial vault exactly as he first discovered it in one of the pyramids. Working for years in absolute and frenzied secrecy, he finally duplicated an ancient mystic formula, which he called the fluid of life. Just before he was found dead, Dr. Jordan had inoculated each of the mummies of the giant guards. They were supposed to return to life. But somehow the test failed. Dr. Jordan was found here at the feet of King Tush. The rest you know. But what you don't know, Mr. Kent, and what I am equally certain of, is that Dr. Jordan violated the ancient warning by attempting to open the coffin of King Tush.
Oh!
needle. That's how Dr. Jordan was killed.
Yes, and Miss Hogan is a free woman.
Who told you I was at the museum?
My mummy done told me.